Namaskar students and welcome. In this video, we are going to start with a new lesson of 7 maths, direct and inverse proportion. So let's begin. See children, this is an example of direct proportion. We are cross multiplying in this. And this is an example of inverse variation. We are straight multiplying it. Name is direct, but the multiplication is inverse. Name is inverse, but the multiplication is direct. Now let's see the difference between direct proportion and inverse proportion. In this, when one quantity increases, the other related quantity also increases. Example, if one pen is costing 10 rupees, then two pens will cost 20 rupees. You have taken more number of pens, so you are going to pay more amount. So when one quantity is increasing, other quantity is also increasing. If you take 10 pens, then it will become 100 rupees. Now, inverse proportion. In this, when one quantity increases, the other related quantity decreases. Let's understand it through an example. Two painters are going to take 6 days to finish the work. Now, if there are 4 painters, they are going to take 3 days. See, when the number of painters have increased, the number of days they will take for completing work are decreasing. So, when one quantity is increasing, other quantity is decreasing. That is inverse proportion. Now, which method do we use for direct multiplication? Cross multiplication method. Normally, we make this kind of a table for solving the sums based on direct proportion and inverse proportion both. 2 pens cost 20 rupees, 10 pens cost 100 rupees. We'll cross multiply, children, because we are using cross multiplication method for direct proportion. 2 into 100 is 200 and 10 into 20 is also 200, children. See, when you cross multiply, both the sides should give the same answer. Method, straight multiplication. For inverse proportion, we use straight multiplication method. See, we have again made the table of painters and days. 2 painters take 6 days and 4 painters take 3 days. We will straight multiply. 2 into 6 is equal to 4 into 3. 2 6s are 12, 4 3s are 12. So children, here also we are getting the same answer on both the sides after straight multiplication. Let's see the practice set 37 now. If 7 kg onions cost 140 rupees, how much must we pay for 12 kg onions? See, we'll make the same kind of a table. Kg, 7 kg and 140 rupees. Kilogram is given and rupees is given. So, we will give the heading kilogram and rupees. And we'll make columns like this. And 12 kg is also given. So, 12 kg will come below the kg group only. So, 7 kg, 140 rupees, this one and this one. And 12 kg, question mark. How much must we pay? We have to find out. So, we are writing x in place of question mark. And what type of variation is this one? It is direct variation, children. So, when it is direct variation, the method is going to be cross multiplication. So, we'll cross multiply 7 into x and 12 into 140. So, we will write 7 into x is equal to 12 into 140. See, and now we want to find the value of this unknown quantity, which is x. So, we will shift this into 7 to other side of is equal to, and because it is multiplication, it will become division when it goes on the other side. That we are going to write in the denominator form. See, x is equal to 12 into 140 upon 7. We have divided. 140, 7 ones are 7 and 7 twos are 14. 0 is already there. So we are writing 20. 7 ones are 7. 7 twos are 14 and 0, 20. X is equal to 12 into 20. This has become 1. So divided by 1 is going to give us same answer. So 12 into 20. 12 twos are 24 and 0 will be 240. See, we got 240. Therefore, we must pay rupees 240 for 12 kg onions. This question is over. Now let's see the next question. If 600 rupees buy 15 bunches of feed, how many will 1280 rupees buy? So we are making the table, children, of rupees and bunches. 600 rupees are buying 15 bunches. So 1280 rupees. This rupees you write below rupees only, children. And this is question mark. How many will 1280 rupees buy? So how many bunches is not given, we have to find out. So put a question mark. In place of question mark, we are assuming an unknown variable X. You can write Y, you can write A, B, C, you can write any alphabet, children. It is direct variation. Because when rupees are increasing, bunches will also increase. You pay more rupees, you get more bunches. You pay less rupees, you get less bunches. So it is a question of direct variation. When it is direct variation, you are going to cross multiply. See, 600 into X is equal to 1280 into 15. So we are going to cross multiply. See, and now we are going to shift this 600 to the other side of is equal to. It is multiplied. So when it goes to the other side, it will become divided. X is equal to 1280 into 15 upon 600. This 0 and this 0 gets cancelled upon 600. So let's see how it got cancelled. 15 ones are 15. 15 fours are 60. This 0 and this 0 have got cancelled, children. 15 ones are 15, 15 fours are 60. Now 4 ones are 4 and 4 32s are 128. 4 threes are 12 and 4 twos are 8. That's how we cancelled this 128 by 4. X is equal to 32 because 1 and 1. So what remains in all this is only 32. So X is equal to 32. Therefore, we can buy 32 bunches of feed in 1280 rupees. So this question is also over. Now question number 3, children. For 9 cows, 13 kg 500 gram of food supplement are required every day. In the same proportion, how much will be needed for 12 cows? Okay, so if the number of cows are increasing, the food they take will also increase. So this is an example of direct proportion. If there are more cows, food they will need will be more. And if there are less cows, they will need less food. So, cows and food. This column, children, you have to make thoughtfully. Think, read the question carefully, and then you decide for these headings and make the columns. For 9 cows, see 9 cows, 13.500. Because we cannot write 13 kg 500 gram, children, in the calculation. So I have written 13.500. And 12 cows, right below the cows only, children. 12 cows, question mark. We have written X in question mark place. So now this is an example of a direct proportion. And when it is direct proportion, cross multiply. 9 into X is equal to 12 into 1. 12 into 13.500. See, we have written the same, and now we are going to shift this 9 to the other side of is equal to. Into 9 is going to become divided by 9. See, now we will cancel 9 ones are 9, and this is getting cancelled by 9 children. 9 ones are 9 and 9 fives are 45. So here 1 is remaining. So what will remain? 12 into 1.500. See, after multiplication, we are getting 18.000. Therefore, 18 kg food supplement will be needed for 12 cows. That's our answer, children. And we finished 3 questions of practice set 37. We will continue the remaining questions in the next video.
Thank you for watching till the end.